Psalm 27 says, I believe that I shall look upon the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord, be strong, and let your heart take courage. Wait for the Lord. And man, I love hearing y'all sing. And we just sang a song that said, walking around these walls, I thought by now they'd fall. But Lord, you have never failed me yet. A big wall sort of fell down this week as Roe v. Wade was overturned. It's worth celebrating, worth clapping for sure. And as a pastor at this church, you know, I'm standing there feeling the weight of just our world that desperately needs Jesus. And we are right to celebrate when you see a glimpse of righteous judgment in a temporal way on the earth. And we have seen our God's hand in the land of the living. 63 million babies have been aborted. Perhaps you're here today and you've had an abortion, and we love you and we see you and we care for you. And we want you to be in and among us this morning. And we want to point you to the Lamb who has conquered death that we just sang about. And Micah 6:8 says, what does the Lord require of me but to do justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God? And, you know, we celebrate justice. We celebrate things that the Lord has called us to celebrate. And life is a gospel issue. Jesus came, Jesus created, God is a creator God. He knit us together in our mother's womb. We are fearfully and we are wonderfully made. And so we celebrate temporal life, but we do not lose sight of eternal life. And we as believers have the message of reconciliation, the message of hope that we point all of the world to, all of the brokenness to. And while political polarization happens all over our nation, we have the answer as the people of God who have been called out of darkness into his marvelous light. And we love mercy and we do justly, but we must walk humbly with God, humbly among one another. While you have hope today because of a decision, many are found hopeless and they need the compassion of Jesus Christ radiating from the church of Jesus Christ. So now more than ever, this is a moment for the church to rise up. This is a moment for the church to pray. This is a moment for the church to be known by what they're for rather than what they're against. This is a moment for the church to be salt and light in the world. This is a moment for the church to come along widows and orphans and abused women and those who have gone through horrendous things and show them that the love of Jesus Christ can bring wholeness to their life and their situation. And so can I encourage you, church, let's have eyes like Christ has eyes on the world that's around us. And let's be known by what we're for more than what we're against. We are for people. We are for the glory of God. We are for the restoration of the gospel of Jesus Christ, that Jesus died on a cross in your place as a substitute for your sin. We're constantly pointing people there because that alone brings life eternal. That alone can save your soul. Amen.